What is metachromasia? Hello everyone and welcome to the Air Anatomy channel. Metachromasia comes from two words. Meta, the word, actually means after, but you can take it as different or modified. And chromasia denotes color. So metachromasia is a phenomenon where parts of the tissues will take different colors from the one that was used to stain. Let me illustrate this out with a basic blue stain called the toluidine blue. If toluidine blue is used to stain something, it will obviously stain it blue, but surprisingly, a few areas will be colored purplish to red, depending upon the peculiarity of that tissue. This phenomenon was found out by the great Nobel Prize winner Paul Ehrlich, a German physician, immunologist, and pharmacologist, known better as the father of immunology. Now let us see three normal tissues that can show metachromasia. One is the hyaline cartilage, the next is the plasma cell, and the next is mast cell granules. Now let us take a deeper dive into what's the reason why these tissues shows these different colors when it is stained with toluidine blue. If toluidine blue stain is used in this tissue, for example, most of the regions will take a blue stain, as you can see here, because the toluidine blue dye molecules will remain as monomers, and that is called as orthochromasia, means it will take the original blue color, which is the color of the dye that is used. But if you take these mast cell granules, there you can see that the dye molecules, instead of remaining as monomers, they will aggregate together and form polymers, and that will have a different light absorption characteristic, which makes it appear purple to red depending upon the degree of polymerization of that dye molecules. This phenomenon is known as metachromasia. Now, what's the peculiarity of mast cells and these granules to make it metachromatic? If you look at the mast cell granules in a transmission electron microscopy, you can see the mast cell, this is the nucleus, and it is studded with a lot of granules. And the composition of the granules are, they are glycosaminoglycans containing heparin as well as heparin sulfate. These are basically polyanions. And you know, polyanions will adhere to a basic dye such as toluidine blue. Toluidine blue is said to be a strong base, unlike the hematoxylin, which is used in most of our staining methods, which is one of the weak bases. Now, toluidine blue will aggregate on this polyanions, and that will create a different absorption characteristic, where it will absorb all the shorter wavelengths and only the longer wavelengths will be remaining. That is, the red longer wavelengths will be remaining, and that creates that color shade. So as the tissue contains more and more polyanions, there will be more aggregation and more polymerization of the dye molecules, creating it metachromatic. The other tissues that show metachromatic will be hyaline cartilage, which will contain glycosaminoglycan, the chondroitin sulfate. That is the polyanion that will create metachromasia in hyaline cartilage. And if you look at plasma cell, it will contain a lot of rough endoplasmic reticulum, which again is highly anionic, because rough endoplasmic reticulum contain a lot of ribosomal RNA, which is again anionic. Now, these are the three normal tissues that can show metachromasia. Thank you.